G'day everyone, it's Clayton from Planet Canada. Part of reaching that next level in cabinet vision as a power user is starting to understand how to take advantage of some of the different system parameters available to us to make smarter parts, you know, dynamic cabinets that adapt themselves automatically to their environment or the circumstances of the project. You know, what we're always trying to do in cabinet vision is elevate the quality of our work while maximizing how efficiently we can produce them. Today, we're gonna focus on one of those system parameters, and that's the no CNC parameter. Something I've seen in the shops that I've worked in or with is that we'll run and nest a whole bunch of kickers in one go and just create a little stockpile for ourselves for future jobs. Great. But of course, as these future projects join us in the present and we're drawing them up, cabinet vision is going to want to nest all of the parts that are there, even if, you know, we've been economical and we've got our kickers ready to go. Well, every time we add the no CNC parameter to cabinet vision, we can actually stop it from appearing, that part from appearing in the S2M Center tab and being optimized. So it's really simple to do. Let me show you how. I've got my part here and I've detached the toe, so it's a separate piece. If I was to go to S2M Center, of course, we'll see that my toe is there in the list. There you go, we've got the front toe there, and then, you know, even the side toes and the different parts of that. But let's say we don't want this toe from being sent to the nester because we've, like we've said, we've already got a stockpile of kickers ready to go. It's really simple. I'm just going to click on the part, right click, properties, parameters, and I'm going to add a new parameter, and the parameter is underscore no CNC, and we're going to change that value to 1, because what we're telling cabinet vision now is this parameter is true, it is relevant, and true here means this part is not being sent to the CNC. Click OK and OK, and now if we reload S2M Center, we can see now that we don't have any of the toe parts or the toe at all appearing in the list. So you know, it's very simple to do, and of course it's the exact same principle if we want to add no CNC to any of our other parts. So I can go into my cabinet, go to any of the views, the plan, end, or face view, and then I can go properties, parameters, and then add the parameter underscore no CNC and make that true. Okay. And okay, and now we won't see that finished right end in the list either. And of course, it's very simple to undo if we want. So if I was to re-click on my finished right end, right click, and then properties, parameters, I can just click on no CNC and delete, and this part will be sent to S2M Center again. So you're probably thinking of some of the different ways that you can now put this parameter into use. One little tip I've got for you is, you know, if it is the kind of thing where you do use a lot of kickers that are already stored and stockpiled in your factory, you can save, if you want, as a new object, your kicker that has the no CNC attribute attached. So you go, just make sure that this box is ticked, and then you could just do something like, you know, toe does not nest, you know, or any other name that you can think of. And then every time, oh, that's right, make sure you save it to the right catalog. and then every time you go to use this part, it's going to have the no CNC parameter saved to it, and it's not going to be sent to the S2M Center. So we hope that helps, and we hope that it's something that you can put into action and become, you know, even more comfortable in using the program. Hey, thanks again for watching. And we're wrapped to announce that we're going to be launching soon an online learning platform that is going to help you learn and master cabinet vision at your very own pace. So if you'd like to learn more or sign up to be a beta tester and receive exclusive early access, please feel free to click on the link in the description below.